myself away. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away.
Lord, have mercy.
What would happen?
I give myself away.
Embrace this.
So you.
Come on, tell me.
Here I am. Here I am. Here I stand. Lord, my life is in your hands. Lord, I'm longing to so you can use me. I give myself away.
Hallelujah.
I give myself away so you can use me.
Take my heart.
Take my heart. Take my my life is not my own. To you I belong. I give myself, I give myself to you. My life is not my own. To you I belong. I give myself, I give myself to you.
Hallelujah.
My life is not my own. To you I belong. I give myself, I give myself to you.
Hallelujah.
My life is not my own.
My life is not my own.
I belong
to you. To you I belong.
So I give myself.
I give myself. I give myself to you.
Hallelujah.
My life is not my own. To you I belong.
I give myself away.
I give myself.
So
I give myself to you.
I give myself away.
I give myself away. I give myself away.
I give myself away.
so you can use me.
I give myself away.
Glory to God. Glory to God. The Bible says early one morning, he got up. Somebody say early one morning, he got up. Hey. Hallelujah. Happy New Year. Happy New Year. I greet you all in Jesus' name. I come before you in the name of a prophet. Let us go right into prayer. The Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth remain silent before him. Every head bowed, every eye closed. Eternal Father, the God of all grace, the God of all flesh, the God of Abraham, the God of Daniel, the God of the living. Lord God, we come today giving ourselves to you. Master, we call you Yahweh. Tabushanaha. Father God, I come against every demonic spirit from hell. Master, I bind Jezebel. Tabushanaha. I bind Satan. I bind Beelzebub. I bind every witch, every warlock, every root worker, every sorcerer. I bind them all. Cast them all down back to hell from where they come. I command them to get out of my ministry right now in Jesus' name. Get out of my house in the name of Jesus. Master, I pray for my team. I pray for deliverance from anything that the devil has bestowed upon them. I pray for guidance for my team. I pray for instructions for my team. I pray for healing for my team. I pray for blessings in the name of Jesus. And I bless your holy name for it. Hallelujah. Master, I pray for Kneecat Network. I pray for Peg Studio. I pray for big time blessings. Ha! Have your way with this place. In the name of Jesus, and I'll give you the honor, give you the glory, give you the praise. Now, Father God, remember your manservant on this hour. Take me higher in Jesus' name. Not my will be done, but let thine will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And I bless your holy name for it in the name of Jesus. Now, Master, send your word. Lord God, send your word. Master, send your anointing. Lord God, send your anointing. In Jesus' precious name, I pray. Lord God, move right now. Move right now. I remove myself. Have your way. In Jesus' precious name, in Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen, amen, and it is so. I give myself away. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. Hallelujah. My text is coming from the book of Revelation, the writing of John the Revelator. Coming from chapter 14, I sincerely solicit your prayers. Happy New Year from the house of bread, from the house of refuge. Hallelujah. In the book of Revelation chapter 14, I'll be reading, pick the reading up at verse 1. And the words of God are recorded like this in the book of Revelation. Hallelujah. Then I looked and behold, a lamb standing on Mount Zion, and with him 144,000 having his father's name written on their foreheads. And I heard a voice from heaven like a voice of many waters and like a voice of a loud thunder. And I heard the sound of the harpists playing their harps. Verse 3, they sang as it were a new song before the throne, before the four living creatures and the elders. And no one could learn that song except the 144,000 who were redeemed from the earth. Verse 4, these are the ones who were not defiled with women, for they are virgins. These are the ones who follow the Lamb wherever he goes.
These were redeemed from among men, being first fruits to God and to the Lamb. Verse 5. And in their mouth was found no deceit, for they are without fault before the throne of God. Then I saw another angel flying in the midst of heaven, having the everlasting gospel to preach to those who dwell on earth, to every nation, tribe, tongue, and people, saying with a loud voice, fear God and give glory to him, for the hour of his judgment has come, and worship him who made heaven and earth, the sea and springs of water. And another angel followed, saying, Babylon is fallen. It's fallen, that great city, because she has made all nations drink of the wine of the wrath of her fornication. Then a third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if anyone worship the beast and his image and receive his mark on their forehead or on their hands, he himself shall also drink the wine of the wrath of God, which is poured out full strength into the cup of his indignation. He shall be tormented with fire and brimstones in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb. And the smoke of their torment ascends forever and ever, and they have no rest day and night, who worship the beast and his image, and whoever receives the mark on his name. Here is the patience of the saints. Here are those who keep their commandments of God and the faith of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Saints of God, my text on this day, doomed to come on worshipers of the beast. Doomed to come on worshipers of the beast. John the Revelator here is speaking about Satan, Lucifer. The mark, 666, will be taken on their foreheads, on their hands in the last days. The Bible speaks of that when man must take on the mark, or he can't buy things, he can't go around in public, you must submit to the beast and his image. But it says those that kept God's commandment, hallelujah, you will receive life, eternal life. He talks about the image, amen, that when Satan is running free, and he says that the beast, those that worship the beast, shall be tormented day and night with fire of brimstone. Hallelujah. He's talking about hell. Hell is real. I've never seen anybody wish anybody happy birthday in hell. But when you look on social media, when people writing and posting things, when someone has died and gone on and it's their birthday on earth, they wish them a happy heavenly birthday. The bishop has already spoke this to you. There is no birthdays in heaven. There isn't. But they talk about it. I don't come to beat you up. I come to help the house. You must know the truth, and the truth will set you free. When a man leaves this earth and puts on whatever body, where he's going, he does not age. It's over. He don't owe no bills. Everything is shut down. But I've never seen or heard anybody wish their loved ones that's passed on happy birthday in hell. They don't mention hell. Do you know, Tabo Shah, that when you always only talk about heaven and you never mention hell? I just read to you from the Bible, the gospel, which that word translates into the truth. That ain't nothing. No one could take you out of the format to where you would block these out. That is a trick of the devil himself. His biggest trick, his biggest illusion is to make you think he does not exist. Hallelujah. Hell is real. Thank you, Master. And those that worship the beast shall be tormented with fire and brimstone, the lake of fire, that never goes out, and you won't be consumed. It's torment. That's hell. Wake up. Wake up. 2024 is the time for you to speak the truth of knowledge and wisdom. Doom comes to those that worship the beast. When you worship the beast, all you do is party, hardy, all night long. Somebody say you're burning the candle at both ends. And when you realize that when that great day comes, that when God stops your clock from ticking, that's when Satan tells you, come on in. He's already got you baffled. He loves it when you don't mention him or talk about hell, talk about heaven. He loves it. It's a trick. It's a trick. Hallelujah. You must understand that in order for you to mature in Christendom, you must be willing to know that there is a way. There's a way that a man must walk. There's things that a man must cut loose, put down, get rid of, be delivered from. But you want to talk about everybody is happy, everybody's in heaven. If that's the case, we wouldn't need preachers. Tabashanama, we wouldn't need bishops, prophets even. If that's the case, why waste time me staying up, burning the midnight oil, studying the word of God so I can release the truth into your presence? So why do these things if we can just get butt naked and run down Broadway and be high as a kite? Because we're going to heaven, we're going to heaven, we're going to heaven. There is nothing wrong with that. That's insane. That's insanity. My God, you understand that hell is real. The devil is real. His imps and demons are real. You have a devil to fight. You have a spiritual enemy to fight. The Bible declares, the apostle writes in Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10, he says, put on the whole armor of God. He says, we do not wrestle against flesh and blood. Talking about your fight is not against man. It's not against humanity, but we fight against powers, rulers of darkness in heavenly places. Ta-ta. Now, you get confused when you say heavenly places. No, no, this is Satan's heaven. He is the god of the atmosphere. The earth is his heaven. Tabo Shanaha. God declares that heaven is my dwelling place, and the earth is my footstool. Tabashanaha. I heard John the Revelator say he saw a new Jerusalem. He saw a new heaven and earth. The Bible teaches that heaven and earth shall pass away, but God's word will stand forever. Isaiah writes that the flowers may wilter, and the grass may wilter and the flowers may fade, but the word of God will stand forever. You understand that those that worship the image and the beast himself shall be thrown into utter darkness, gashing of teeth, a lake that's fueled by brimstone. Brimstone is an accelerant. It's something that brings the heat beyond measure. You're going to hell if you don't straighten your hell bent. But I stopped by to tell my children, I come by to tell the house of bread, huh? And the house of refuge. This is a place of refuge. And Jesus declared that I am the bread of life. In John 6, he says, I'm the bread of life. Hey, and those that believe in me shall never perish. Hey, man, though you die, yet shall you live. You won't die a second death. The Bible speaks in the last days about the second death. Somebody help the bishop. I come to preach right now. The second death is that when you come before the throne, the judgment seat, when you stand before the Almighty God, are you ready for the judgment? There's a judgment, amen, and you must listen to what he says to you. If he greets you and say, well done, my good and faithful servant, come on in, but if he looks off and tells Satan, because he says, depart from me, I never knew you, you worker of iniquity. But you say that we preached in your name. We prayed in your name. We did these things in your name. But the Bible declares that God is not a God that shall lie, and he can't die again. He said, man looks at the outward appearance of a man, but God looks at the heart. You can preach and pray in God's name all you want, but if your heart ain't right, amen, you're serving, worshiping the beast. Let me get my feet up under me. I hear the Holy Ghost saying, preach, Bishop. Preach, Bishop. Happy New Year. I want you to go into the new year and receive what God has for you. You can't get what God has for you when you worshiping the beast. Let me help you with the beast's tools. You're working with the devil's tools. Amen. Every narcotic, every marijuana stick you pick up. I said it's a stick because it is. It's whipping you. Every crack, a rock that you, every line of pot of cocaine that you snag. I used to snag it. Yes, I didn't, because I was good. I had a Hoover. I go, hey, Babashita, huh? And one day, I was in intensive care. Not for one day, for 4 days. And then 4 days on upstairs in a room, the devil tried to kill me with the things that I was working with. The thing that I thought I loved tried to take me out of here before I begin to stand behind the sacred desk. But I come to tell you, those are the tools of the beast. These are the mark of the beast. You said, prove it, preacher. Can I teach? When you look at a crackhead, that's what they are. They know it. When you look at a crackhead, you say, show me the mark, Bishop. Look at his bottom lip. That's the mark. You know, sometimes some of them, it's burnt all on the inside because they can't put it down. See, you thought you picked it up on your own, but you can't put it down on your own. You didn't pick it up on your own. Amen. No, you didn't. See, you was enticed to do it. See, when you smoke that, you become highly intelligent, so you say. I've heard people say when they smoke crack, they become inventors, entrepreneurs. Entrepreneurs. Do you know the devil standing over here like the car? He ain't really laughing. He just snickering. He ain't laughing. He's snickering at you because he got you all sewed up because you worshiping a beast. Let me get up off of that. Let me get up off of that. Good God. Am I making any sense to you? I know what I know. I know what I know. The Bible says you worship in the beast. Let me look in 15. Help me, Holy Ghost. I feel the power of the Holy Ghost. Let me look here in 15 and 1. It says, then I saw another sign in heaven, great and marvelous, seven angels having the seven last plagues of in them the wrath of God complete. Verse 2, and I saw something like a sea of glass mingled with fire, and those who have the victory over the beast, over his image, and over his mark, and over the number of his name stands on the sea of glass, having harps of God. They sang the song of Moses, the servant of God, and the song of the Lamb, saying, great and marvelous are your works. Lord God Almighty, just and true are your ways, O King of the saints. Who shall not fear you, O Lord? My glorify your name. For you alone are holy. For all nations shall come and worship before you. For your judgments have been manifested. You're going to be judged on the day. Hallelujah. Those that worship the beast. Amen. Doom is coming. Doom. Do you know what doom means? Doom is a word. Mm-hmm. It really does not do justice to what hell is. The Bible declares that hell is real. Mm-hmm. The Bible calls it hate us. You are headed for a devil's hell. But I come to tell somebody, when you hear his voice, soften your heart, because your salvation is nearer than you first thought. You've got to come in and say, Lord God, forgive me of all my many sins. Blot them out. Throw them in your lake of forgiveness. Lord God, save me. Lord God, help me. And the God of Jacob will redeem you, because God declares any man that repents shall receive victory over the image of the beast. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You need victory on New Year. And then he'll welcome you. He'll welcome you. Come on. My good and faithful servant. Hey, Mama Shana. Atabe Kaka. Ababa Kika. Heta Mosana. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I heard you, Lord. I heard your Holy Ghost. I heard it. Thank you, Lord. Amen. 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 Hatabo. I mean, be happy. Don't let the devil steal your joy, baby. Huh? Huh? I know. I know. He can't steal it if he ain't real, right? Right? He's real, child. Listen to me, children. It's real. It's real. Hey. Yes. It's real. But we got victory. We got victory over the image, over the beast, over the name, the mark. 666 is the mark.